Hello, 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 all you wonderful, beautiful people.
Hey guys.
And guess what? We're together again. Neither one of us are 100%. I'm still getting over bronchitis.
I'm modeling accessibility by wearing all of my migraine gear. You're welcome.
Yes. So, if you're new to the channel, this is Gangalized Treasures.
Hi. We're usually a lot peppier than this.
Yes, we are usually a lot peppier than this. But bronchitis has...
Go back a few episodes. We were peeing our pants laughing at one time.
I don't even remember where we went. But yes, you should go back and check that one out. And again, if you're new to the channel, welcome. We used to try to thrift mid-century modern antique, but we've realized that people are changing what they buy. So we are having to change what we buy to resell. So we are open to many more categories.
Many baby boxes.
And we have a box of those.
We just finished moving, so we've had a lot of discussions about
boxes
and stuff is too big to have in the shop, and we can't buy furniture for the shop because there's the house, the moving, and
And they haven't finished the basement. They've got to come in and put in a drain system in the basement because the house was built when?
1947.
We just found out the house was built in 1947.
It's a cute little bungalow. It's going to be even better when everything works.
Yes, when everything works. So today was, I'd like to put the dining room together. Oh, we haven't found the screws to put my mom's antique table back together. Well, I'll go put the coffee bar together. Oh, that means I have to move all the plants. Well, then I have to move the temporary coffee bar. Well, no, I'm not going to do that. So, and bronchitis. So, we are going to go thrifting and do some retail therapy.
And find some good stuff.
We are going, we are at the St. Vincent De Paul thrift store. I believe we are in St. Anne.
St. Anne, Missouri.
In the St. Louis area. So, we will see you in a blink of an eye. We walked in and realized they have the music on, so this is going to have to be a voiceover, and this is just a short little part of the furniture. I did look at some wardrobes, but I was looking at them to use in the house because there are no closets. Well, not no closets at all, but no coat closets in the living room. So we're going to head straight to the hard goods, and if you want to see the furniture, I will tack it on the end after we say goodbye. We did look at this wrought iron. You know, it's one of those things I like because I like modern, organic style. We were thinking about hanging plants on them outside, but we decided to leave them. And this row was just basically baskets and metal, and there was a fireplace screen there, and the other side was just baskets, and Ramanda picked that up and said, oh look, an offering plate. Excuse my coughing. They had a little bit of Christmas on the aisle, and I wanted to check this end cap also. I thought this bowl was interesting, but it had no maker's mark. I could have bought it for whatnot. This looked like it had some age, but still wasn't that vintage style. And I would have liked to have seen the words Italy on it. If it had been Italian or possibly Czechoslovakian, I would have gotten it. We are in the decorations aisle. Does have some coffee cups and some lights. And I picked that up and... was a lot lighter than I thought. Quite contemporary. The top one might actually have some age, but not much. Not much in this aisle, but you always look because you never know what you're gonna find. This plate was very pretty with all of the spring colors. And it does have a mark on the back, but since we've already passed Easter, I decided to leave it. And again, there's a big difference between shopping to sell on whatnot and shopping to sell on eBay. let's go to the other side. There's a little bit of Halloween. These are some sun catchers. There's a whole bag of them. Looks like somebody had a kit and then decided not to keep them. These are Christmas ornaments. They were all small, but I didn't see anything spectacular in it. That wreath down there on the bottom shelf, I think I have that exact same wreath for fall. Oops, that's what I wanted to see. Was that together and what was it? But it's not together. Some lights. Another little baggie. Little gingerbread plate. And some plastic buckets. The little gold trinket box. This was cute. I was hoping you would have Illy on the bottom. Nope. E7263. Some great bowls on the bottom. Sango. The style is Bordeaux. Some of the Sango larger serving bowls and plates sell well. Purple cup. Asked Ramanda if she wanted a purple cup. This is from the Gourmet Village, but was made in China. Would be cute if you had a Mediterranean style kitchen. And this was really cute. And now that I think about it, everything else that we got, oops, I just, spoiler alert. I probably should have got that. We could have sold that on Whatnot. And I do go through the glass. I have found crystal infused glass sometimes. This was interesting, but it was Mikasa. The one right beside it, which was Mikasa also, but it was clear. They wanted $8.25. This I picked up and it was so thin. I wondered if it had a pontal scar or if it was a poured. And so I had to ask Ramanda. And we decided that it was a poured glass. Picture frames. If you ever need picture frames, go to Goodwill. Don't go buy $6 or $7 for a picture frame when you can get them at Goodwill for $2.25 or $2.50. These were pretty because they matched and had those nice spring colors. Maxera. Group floral made in China. This one looks like it has some age, and it is from Japan, but for selling on eBay, it doesn't have the sell-through rate needed, which means there are a lot of them listed and not very many of them sell. Ramanda found these really cute puppy kitty plates. She says she likes that kitty better. It is the What's Up from Mixed Company plate collection. We did look them up and there were dozens of them, dozens and dozens and dozens, maybe like over 1,000, and none sold or one sold. She found this hand painted, I thought it was a lid, but then I realized it's a magnet and she decided to take that home. Then she found these oriental, they are a porcelain ceramic face, hands, and feet, but they are a hand puppet, or they're called an opera puppet. We had to check them over, make sure there were no stains. Then we spent some time looking them up and looking at each one. There was three. There was one that was sold on eBay for like $200, but it was very intricate and had a lot of detail and a lot of embroidery on it. These three were not popular. They wanted $3 a piece, would have been $9. We could have listed it for $15, but not very many of them have sold. Again, checking the clear glass, you might find some crystals, some Fostoria. Sometimes people put other glass in here. Those are banana split bowls. Let's check the end cap. There's some smoked glass down there. These are cute little pots. They did have a pottery. Oh, that one's made in Taiwan. Maybe the one of the other, checked with the other ones. Anyway, I left them on the shelf. The octagon black coffee cup. I used to have the whole set. Baskets on the end cap. Life is better in flip-flops. Yes. And again, there's that wrought iron that I like, but there was only one. More baskets. These are contemporary. I'm more interested in the amber glass, but it is contemporary also. That has a nice little vase and cute flowers. 2 1/4 is going in the cart. I think it's the first thing we decided to get, but we decided to get it for the house. I want the house to have lots of color. Colorful, modern, organic. And Ramanda says, who would want fish? Well, probably somebody that maybe likes the coast or lives on the coast or has a beach house. Coffee cups. I check the coffee cups. As I've said before, coffee cups, I'm looking for a pottery coffee cup, or looking for one that's The Simpsons or some other TV show that everybody's talking about. These were interesting. It's a box. It's got a whole bunch of these little, I'm having trouble opening it with one hand. Let's see if I can do it. A lot of these little pots in there. And I was like, okay, there's a sponge in a pot. I don't get it. And so Armand had to come explain it to me. You take the sponge out and put the makeup in, and then you can have makeup in it. She goes, oh, look, this looks nice. It does look vintage, and it's made to look vintage, but it is FTD floral. Yes, we live in the city. Yes, that is a helicopter going overhead. I'm going to check out this platter. But if I was going to get it, I probably would have gotten it for my coffee bar. But I have a... Ramanda really likes these. They're like birch tree. See her shake them. That's a hint that she likes them. They go with her cottage core that she likes. Anyway, I have a tray that I'm going to have made for my coffee bar. Oh, I can't read it. That's upside down. False graft. Darn. I thought maybe it was going to be Blue Ridge pottery or Pigeon Forge pottery. Lots of utensils. Pocket pies. And look, you can have candy on your cheese spreader. If you wanted one, I might want one of those cheese spreaders, but not 14 of them or 8 of them. How many was in the... So now we have 3 things. Ramanda found a spoon rest that she put, but she didn't show it to me. I'm going to go back and check the end cap. I thought maybe this was fused glass. It was not. It's got the plain glass on the other side. It's painted in the middle. So. I thought this was going to be ceramic, and it wasn't. Cromwell, made in Denmark. It's plastic. I was almost excited. Cute little figurines. Christmas snow scene. Christmas plates with ivy all the way around. Noritake. It had been saucers and cups, or if there had been plates and salad plates and bowls that I could have made sets. This was Royal Dalton. They are the collector's plates. These were cute, but they didn't have a maker's mark. But they did look like they were older than most of the other plates on the shelves. Ramanda's like, I like these. okay. We're having trouble at our house because we can't find the plates. She said there was a mark in there, there was some number or initials or something. See how that has two plates and two saucers to make sets. That's what I'm really looking for when I'm looking for plates, or if I was looking for plates, it has the salad plate, a serving plate, and dinner plates. Ramanda has decided that she likes the fish plates, but she thinks that all the fish plates should go together. So we're moving all the fish plates, so all the big fish and all the baby fish plates can be together. We're going to turn them all the same way, so they're all swimming the same way. They're all together in their little family pod. Dolphins are a pod. Theodore Holland. A lot of these single plates, I do look them up, but a lot of times single plates don't have a lot of resale value. Ramanda likes those because they're stoneware. They're nice and heavy, and that's why I don't like them. With the three bulging discs I have in my neck, picking up heavy plates out of the dishwasher or out of the cabinet isn't the best. I wanted to see these plates and the ones under here, but one-handed I couldn't lift those up either. So I'd have Ramanda come move them for me. Teamwork, teamwork. Oh, they're square. Okay, thank you. Not what I thought they were gonna be. These are all chipped up. Ugh. Didn't fancy me enough to even hold the plate long enough for you to read it. Sorry. And this is a plastic section. I, you know, just kind of buzz over that. This was a nice stainless steel to-go cup. Gotta check plates one more time. Did I miss anything? Be sure I look at the bottom. Did I miss anything on the top? This says art glass. Oh, wine and grapes and cheese and pears and a wine glass. $2.25. That would make a nice serving dish. And more cottagecore plates that Ramanda likes. And sometimes you pick them up and the tag is on the bottom and the tag covers up the maker's mark. And you have to decide whether you want to try and peel it really carefully. Most thrift stores are not happy when you take the tag off. They don't want to lose the tag for the pieces. We're talking about artwork now. In artwork, I would be looking for an actual painted canvas, not a print or a poster, not a copy. Unless it was signed and it was somebody that I knew. I was gonna check this one to see if it had a signature on the back or how much they wanted for it. And that one actually was painted. You could feel the paint on the canvas. They did have a few golf clubs, a few golf bags, some books, some DVDs, some CDs, some roller skates, some empty. Don't know whether those are computer or CDs, DVDs for copies. Some exercise, some 2-pound barbells. And then Ramanda said that that was material. So I was like, well, we haven't gone down this aisle because there was somebody in the aisle. And these were cute, but they were chipped. Check the other end cap. Those are very pretty. Pastel-y colors for spring. Desert flower. Made in China. I'm sure there's somebody's style, not mine. Pretty bowl. I have bowls somewhere in my house. I need to find them. Sunflower bowls. Now this one down here was a whole set. As you can see, it has some of all the dishes. It doesn't have the same amount of everything. But I told Ramanda if she was going to buy for a rental that she should get that set because she'd get more pieces for the price. She didn't necessarily like that idea. I said, or you could just go to Target, which she probably wouldn't. In the games, I'm mostly looking for games that are still sealed, that are brand new. Used games don't seem to sell very well. In toys, I'm looking for the vintage, the wooden. And Ramanda found a Cootie keychain set. If any of you remember the Cooties, 1989, 1999. Anyway, those went in the basket and they have dolls. And some of them are very pretty. This one is porcelain and is very pretty. But I don't know enough about dolls to know whether it's a good buy or what to resell them for. So I left them on the shelf. Teddy bear. For plushes, I'm usually looking for the bigger plushes. If it was a Squishmallow, I would take it. Some of the Build-A-Bear ones can sell well, but again, you have to look all of them up. This I thought was really cute, but it says not for food use, may poison the food. I don't want to have a teapot that's going to poison my tea. I really like the celadon glaze on this. But it would not have the sell-through rate on eBay. Look, it's a cup that has Kansas on it, Ramanda. Not as cute as the one that she has. That was very contemporary. I could tell by looking at the colors and by how light it was. And the front of the cart is empty. They have light bulbs. And I think this is almost the last aisle. This is the lamps. In the lamps, I am looking for hand-blown glass lamps, slag glass, possibly wooden handmade. But I didn't see any, and I didn't see any shades for Ramanda's lamp. So I wanted to check the appliances. You know, I have this thing I like to smell. Blah, nope. Beep. I like to sell small kitchen appliances. The vintage ones can sell quite well. A panini maker. Maybe I should have looked up what those sell for. Let me know in the comments if you've sold panini makers or George Foreman grills. I think this is some kind of vacuum or vacuum attachment. Coffee maker, crock pot, probably a humidifier, a toaster, the base for a blender. Probably should have looked at that more. I should go back and see whether that was a Ninja. What I have that I make my smoothies with. And this is a popcorn popper.
We found some stuff.
But we'll show you. In the hall.
I don't think, is the hall going to be separate?
Yes.
Okay. I don't think any of this stuff is going to end up on eBay. I think it's all cottagecore stuff for whatnot. So.
Changing gears.
I mean, we just didn't find anything that was high enough MSRP. We didn't find crazy treasure crockery or
Well, and the one place that I wanted to look in the small appliance aisle, there was already a gentleman in there doing the exact same thing, and I wasn't gonna bust in front of him for the DVD player or something.
He was really into whatever he was into.
Yeah, he was checking prices and all that stuff too. And I did want to apologize for only having one video yesterday. Again, part of moving in, and we've had one car down. So I've just spent a lot of time at the house trying to get things together.
The house to be a home.
Yeah. It's not there yet.
We looked up a lot of things. Yeah, we stood around forever and looked stuff up, and it just wasn't, like, it would be okay to buy, like, for myself or, like, yeah, for a gift for somebody because thrifting, but it wasn't anything that was like, oh, this is a hoblaw from, you know.
Yeah, but the plate was 1,500,000.
There's so many puppy plates
listed.
And what, 17 sold?
One.
You'd have to have, like, a really special connection.
And then if you took it down to...
to care that much.
To used ones, which if they're that old, I would have just figured they're all used. But
right.
Anyway, there was still, like, 100,000 of them and only one sold. They were adorable. I mean, we could have got those, too. But, again, they would have probably sold.
I would have rather us got the fishy plates.
She had so much fun with the fishy plates, and as you
saw, you need put it in the comments that you need the fish plates. I will go back and get them. There's 2 stacks of big ones and 4 stacks of little ones. You have a whole set of fishy plates. I don't know, maybe they have a beach house, you don't know. That's why it's Gangalized Treasure. Tell us what you're looking for and we will look out for it for you.
That's true. You have adult plates and kitty plates, and can sit at the adult table and the kitty table.
Or it's a salad plate. It could be fancy.
Yeah, with fish.
So we ended up with a bunch of cottagecore stuff for whatnot. It's a bunch of cute stuff. Not a bunch. We have like one Aldi bag. That's it.
It's about half full.
Ignore the
Well, the picture, laundry. The picture actually isn't for sale.
Oh, okay. And also the magnet isn't for sale.
It's going in
the
house.
I got a San Francisco magnet. Because I went to San Francisco on a trip and I worked really hard.
And didn't get a souvenir.
And I got a busted capillary in my foot for it. So I saw this really cute hand-painted magnet that probably nobody has ever cared about. And I was like, I need that on my fridge. So we each got a thing for ourselves, apparently.
Well, I got it for the house just because it
followed by
lots of colors.
Because we have a house now.
Well, and I don't have enough artwork for the house.
I don't have enough artwork for the house.
And it needs lots of color.
Oh, puppy. We're in front of the house.
It's like squirrel. Excuse her.
We're actually in front of the house right now, but we're probably not going to show you today or anytime soon because it's having a lot of work done. But we will show you the cute cottagecore things in the hall. Are they going to be offered on Gangalized Treasure's new whatnot store, or am I going to do a pop-up?
I don't know. We need to talk about that.
We should follow Crystal Clear Downloads on whatnot either way.
And TikTok.
That's where we are.
And you should follow Gangalized Treasures on Instagram. I and Instagram eBay. And she TikToks.
I TikToks?
TikToks. She ticks and she talks.
Those sometimes TikTok make too much noise. Yes or no?
Sometimes she does them both together. Ticks and talks. So, be sure and hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, so you'll be notified when the haul is up. And if you haven't seen the house tour video, I did do a house tour video when everything was empty. And now everything is just boxes. Well, not really. I mean, there's some boxes.
She worked really hard to make the living room a room you can live in, so.
Yeah, but it's, I don't have a couch.
Yet.
So it's chairs instead of couches, and I don't have the wardrobes I want. And
it's a work in progress. Yes. I'm so much happier camping out in the house than I've ever been in any state of any apartment.
Except for your little hobbit
Except
hole.
Except for my hobbit hole. Yeah.
But now you have a hobbit hole bedroom.
Now I have a hobbit loft, so it's good. I told, before all this, I didn't know that I needed to be on the second story and see trees all the time. But apparently that's what I need for my mental health.
I just need the backyard. So I go out barefoot in the backyard.
We're gonna set up the shop and be filming in there when we're having hauls and future whatnot shows. So you guys will get to see inside the house eventually.
Yes. And then again, part of the problem is we can't set up our shop because the house was built in 1947 and it has cinder block walls. So there's water coming in through the walls. We did paint the in.
There's a bird hanging out on our handrail.
Side
right
of
now.
The inside of the walls with waterproof paint. But if you follow me on Instagram, you will see the picture that there's at least 2 or 3 inches of water that has seeped out from underneath the wall into the cement.
We're having an adventure, basement. So y'all be patient with us. We're going to keep filming in the car for a while.
Foundation Recovery Systems will be here Wednesday. They're only going to take 2 days. They're going to put a drain system in.
I don't think they care about the plant.
Okay. We appreciate y'all. If you haven't liked and you've watched this far into the video and you like this kind of content,
hit the bell so you can see all the bloopers and see when all the silliness happens.
Hit the like button. Leave us a comment. Let us know if you saw something that we should have gotten. Of course, it'll be a voiceover. So
we're still working on merch. Uncle Jim's shirt is first, but if you want a shirt or a tote, you should definitely start thinking about.
Yeah, our next decision is it's t-shirts and totes. The next decision is what colors do we want to do?
Tell us what colors you
want to
wear.
Do we just want to do black and white? Do we want to do pink and purple since it's spring?
What is wrong with you?
What?
Black and white. We are some of the most colorful. I know. Will you look at this? Look at this. I am the rainbow.
And the top part is yellow. But, we need to just pick 2 colors.
Y'all tell us your 2 favorite t-shirt colors in the comments, okay?
And, Cousin Jim has already said anything but orange.
Uncle Jim. Uncle Jim.
Anything but orange. So we will catch you on the next one. And as always, remember, you're blessed to be a blessing. Let's go out and make today a great day. And if not, have some ice cream. It'll make the day better.